الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، اللهم إنا نحمدك حمدا طيبا مباركا فيه ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما. لك الحمد بالإيمان وبالإسلام، وأن جعلتنا من خير أمة أخرجت للناس من أمة خير الأنام سيدنا محمد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن، وهو بكل شيء عليم. سبحانه وتعالى: من تكلم سمع نطقه، ومن سكت علم سره، ومن عاش فعليه رزقه، ومن مات فإليه منقلبه. لا تحويه الأقطار، ولا يجري عليه ليل أو نهار، ولا تدركه الأبصار، وهو يدرك الأبصار، وهو اللطيف الخبير. وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أرسله ربه بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله، وكفى بالله شهيدا. فأدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح للأمة، فكشف الله به الأمة، وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم جازني عنا خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ثم أما بعد، we praise Allah, we seek His help and His forgiveness, we seek refuge in Allah from the sins of ourselves and from our wicked deeds. Whosoever has been guided by Allah, there is no one can misguide, and whosoever went astray, there is no one has the ability to guide him but Allah, and I bear witness that there is no one worthy of being worshipped but Allah, and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. May Allah bestow His mercy upon His final prophet Muhammad, his companions and his family, and all those who follow them till the day of judgment. Amin. My dear respected brothers and sisters, Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Our topic today is really important, because this topic might change your life. Your life would be changed because of this topic, if you gonna understand what I'm gonna say today. I'm serious. It is very simple, but it is very important to understand what I'm gonna say today. حديثنا لحضراتكم اليوم في غاية الأهمية، وهو قد يغير مجرى حياتك، لأنك ربما تكتشف اليوم أنك تسير في طريق خاطئ، وأنه ليس لك هدف في الحياة، وليس عندك ما تفعله غير اتباع الواقع وما يمليه عليك الواقع والظروف والأحوال والعادات والتقاليد. Sometimes people are so affected with cultures, the background, the way, you know, they live in this worldly life, sometimes gonna force them to follow the same method or the same guidance in this worldly life. When I explain what I want to say, you will understand better, inshallah. إذا سألت حضراتكم سؤال ما هي أهم الأشياء عندك في هذه الدنيا؟ The question is, what is the most important thing in this worldly life? Everybody will give different answers. Not because we are in the masjid, you should give the same answer. Oh, the religion is the most important thing in this worldly life because you are here. But if I'm gonna see you in the mall and I ask you the same question, what is the most important thing to for you today, you will say to get the deal, to get my computer, which was $700, now it is $200. This is the most important thing for me. If I'm gonna ask you, if you are a student and you're studying so hard, you know, what is the most important thing to pass the test? If you are a doctor and you're about to have a, you know, to do a surgery for a patient, what is the most important thing? Your answer would be different. If you are an engineer, if you have a shop or a restaurant, if you're doing something, driving a car, anything, your answer would be different. But I'm talking about the whole life, which cannot be separated from the masjid. What is the most important thing of you or for you in this world of life? ما هي أهم الأشياء وأول الأولويات لك أو عندك في هذه الحياة؟ المسجد لا ينفصل بحال من الأحوال عن الحياة. المسجد لا ينفصل. وممارساتك طقوس هذه الحياة لا يجب أن يفترق ولا ينفصل أبداً عما تفعله هنا في المسجد. فهنا الزاد الروحي الذي سيعطيك الطاقة حتى تستطيع أن تمارس حياتك اليومية. الزاد الروحي طاقة تأخذها من المسجد من طاعاتك بشكل عام حتى لو لم تأتي للمسجد. فليس هناك انفصال، بل هناك مصدر تستلهم منه وتستقي منه هذه الطاقة ثم تذهب في حياتك تمارس هذه الحياة. عندنا مشكلة كبيرة في حياتنا، أننا عندنا خلل في الأولويات، لا ندري ما هي أهم الأشياء وأول الأشياء التي يجب أن نراعيها في الحياة. مشكلة كبيرة عندنا الحقيقة. الحل فيها أن نعيد ترتيب الأوراق وأن نبدأ من جديد، وليس أبداً متأخراً أن تبدأ حتى لو بلغت من العمر أرضاً. ليس هناك مشكلة أن تبدأ من جديد، وليس هناك مشكلة أن تعيد ترتيب أوراقك. We have no problem to start again or to restart our life if we're gonna discover that we're doing something wrong or we acting or practicing in this worldly life wrong. There is no problem. But we need to start. We need first to define our goal and make this goal the most important priority of your life. And then you should have a determination, israr wa tasmeem, to achieve your goal, which you made the first priority thing in your life. From the end. عندنا في الفقه الإسلامي باب يسمى باب الأولويات، وهذه مقدمة مفيدة جدا لكل الناس، ستعطيك كثير من المعلومات، يعني كثير من المعلومات سترد لحضراتكم الآن لما تسمع ما هو فقه الأولويات الذي يجب أن نتحدث عنه أو نتحدث عنه على سبيل الاستئناس في موضوعنا اليوم. الفقه هو in English, the deep understanding, the true understanding of something. This is fiqh. And we have categories in the books of fiqh in Islam. فِقْهُ الْعِبَادَاتِ فِقْهُ الْمُعَامَلَاتِ فِقْهُ وَفِقْهُ الْأَوْلَوِيَاتِ. You know, this category for worshipping Allah, this category for dealing with people, this category for priorities. فِقْهُ الْأَوْلَوِيَاتِ. وَبَابُ الْفِقْهِ قَدْ وُضِعَ لِإِرْشَادِ النَّاسِ عَلَى أَنَّكَ لَا تَظُنُّ أَنَّ أَشْيَاءَ أَهَمُّ مِنْ أَشْيَاءَ. يعني على سبيل المثال ذكر في باب فقه الأولويات مثلا أن إنقاذ إنسان أهم من الصلاة. If you are praying right now and somebody seek help because he's burning right now, okay, or something happened to him, so you should leave the prayer and go and save him. أيهما أهم، إنقاذ حياة إنسان أم الصلاة؟ الآن إنقاذ حياة إنسان أهم من الصلاة. أيضا قالوا أن الاستجابة لأمك إذا نادتك أهم من صلاة السنة. When your mom calls you and you are praying the voluntary prayer, it is more important to respond to your mom than continuing your prayer. هذا فقه، فقه الأولويات. إنقاذ حياة إنسان يغرق أفضل ومقدم على نصيحته. The example is very important. Wearing gold bracelet, you know, necklace, gold for men is forbidden in Islam. لبس الذهب محرم للرجال. أكثر من 15 حديث، 15 حديث of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم prohibited that men should wear gold. But if somebody is sinking or drowning right now, okay, and he raises his hand waving, save me, and you found a bracelet or something in his hand made of gold or a ring made of gold, which is more important, to save him or to listen, I need to give you an advice, wearing gold in Islam is forbidden. Which one is more important? To save the guy is more important than advising him right now. So many examples. At the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself taught us things through his lifetime. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to make Hajj or make Umrah, and the people of Mecca stopped him from making Umrah, right? In Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, the treaty of Hudaybiyah. So they start to ask for a treaty. They want to sign a treaty with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know that story, you know, it is very interesting, but I'm going to just quote from this story. The guy, his name is Amr Suhail ibn Amr. He came to negotiate with Muhammad, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they were writing something. Ali ibn Abi Talib was writing the treaty, you know, the conditions of the treaty. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, oh Ali, write down that. هذا عهد بين محمد رسول الله وسهيل ابن عمرو. فقال لو علمت أنك رسول الله ما كذبتك، أنا لا أؤمن أنك رسول الله، ولكن قل بين محمد ابن عبد الله وسهيل ابن عمرو. سهيل ابن عمرو the one who came to negotiate with Prophet Muhammad refused to admit that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. And he refused to sign on the paper which has Muhammad is the messenger of God. He said, I cannot sign that. Delete it. Erase it. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam found it is more important to make this treaty successful than writing Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. So Prophet Muhammad says what? Ali, erase it. Delete it. Wow. Umar ibn Khattab got very upset. And he, oh Prophet of Allah, what are you doing? Prophet of Allah, he refused to admit that you are the messenger of Allah. He said, be patient. You will see. So the priority right now is to make this treaty successful. So Prophet of Allah did what? He accepted. Okay, do it. Having peace for a few years is better than a person can admit or deny that Imam is the messenger of Allah. This is the understanding of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day sent Mu'adh ibn Jabal to Ali.
وقال له يا معاذ إنك تأتي قوما أهل كتاب، فليكن أول ما تدعوهم إليه توحيد الله أو شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله. You know, let the first, he sent Mu'adh ibn Jabal to Al-Yaman. And he told them, you're going to come to people who are Christian at that time. So first priority, you should call people to, is to say there is no God but Allah. And Muhammad is the messenger of God. فَإِنْهُمْ أَجَابُوا لِذَلِكَ If they respond positively to you in this, tell them that Allah, you know, made a commitment upon them, obligation upon them to pray 5 times a day. فَأَخْبِرُهُمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ افْتَرَضَ عَلَيْهِمْ 5 صَلَوَاتٍ فِي الْيَوْمِ يَوْمِ اللَّيْلِ فَإِنْهُمْ أَجَابُوا لِذَلِكَ If they're going to respond positively to that, tell them that أَنَّ اللَّهَ افْتَرَضَ عَلَيْهِمْ زَكَاةَ أَمْوَالِهِمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made an obligation upon them to pay the charity. تُوْخَذُ مِنْ أَغْنِيَائِهِمْ وَتُرَدُ عَلَى فُقَرَائِهِمْ Gonna be taken from the rich people to and given to poor people. تُوْخَذُ مِنْ أَغْنِيَائِهِمْ وَتُرَدُ عَلَى فُقَرَائِهِمْ This is fiqh. This is understanding. Because if they didn't respond positively to the first one, there is no meaning to continue. Okay? So this is fiqh الأولويات. حَتَّى الْمُحَرَّمَاتِ الْمُحَرَّمَاتِ جعلها الله سبحانه وتعالى متباينة ومختلفة في قوة الحرمة في شدة الحرمة Lying is forbidden, right? But Allah سبحانه وتعالى named lying to Allah سبحانه وتعالى or making partners to Allah or claiming that Allah has a son is more forbidden to lying, we know, of lying to people. الكذب على الله أشد أنواع الكذب أن تزعم أن لله ولدا أو زوجة أشد أنواع الكذب رغم أن الكذب كله محرم أشد من الكذب على الناس وإن كان محرما قتل النفس محرم قتل النفس محرم وهذا فيه كلام كثير قتل النفس ولكن قتل المؤمن أشد حرمة عند الله سبحانه وتعالى من قتل أي أحد آخر رغم أن كله محرم قتل النفس البريئة محرم When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا أَنَّ النَّفْسَ بِالنَّفْسِ أَنَّهُ مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ مِنْ أَجْلِ ذَلِكَ كَتَبْنَا عَلَى بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ Allah says, whoever gonna kill an innocent person, Muslim, non-Muslims, most likely here, he is not Muslim. أَنَّهُ مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا Whoever gonna kill an innocent soul or innocent person, Okay, to cause corruption in the land, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says he will be considered the day of judgments as he had killed the whole mankind. هذا أولويات. أشد حرمة من ذلك. Can you imagine to kill a believer? Muslim said لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. If you're gonna kill him intentionally, in purpose, it is more harm than killing the one who, if you're gonna kill him, that be considered as killing the whole mankind. Can you imagine? وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا فَجَزَاؤُهُ جَهَنَّمُ خَالِدًا فِيهَا وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَعَنَهُ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا Look how many things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the one who killed a believer. So, الذُّنُوبُ كُلُّهَا حَرَامٌ لَكِنْ هُنَكَ أَشْيَاءٌ مُحَرَّمَةٌ ولو خيرت بين امرين لن ادخل في هذا الموضوع موضوع شائك شوي لكن لو خيرت بين حرامين وكان يجب ان تفعلهما تفعل واحد منهما تختار الاقل حرمه لو خيرت بين امرين الاثنان بهما ضرر ولكن ضرر هذا اقل من هذا تختار الاقل ضررا هكذا هذا فقه الاولويات سكولر سيكس الأمور على اختلافها أربعة أنواع. We have 4 categories, 4 types of things, matters. What is that? اسمع جيدا عشان تحفظ وتخبر الناس بما سلام. الأمور على اختلاف أنواعهم أربعة أشياء. أربعة أنواع. أمر هام وعاجل. The first category, the things which is very important and very urgent. أمر هام وعاجل وأمر ليس بهام وليس بعاجل and something is not important and is not urgent وأمر هام ليس عاجلا. Something important but not urgent. وأمر هام وأمر عاجل وليس هاما. Something urgent but is not important. Okay, what is that? What are the things which is important and urgent and not important and not urgent and important but not urgent and not urgent but important? What are the things? Everything you're gonna do in this worldly life, you can apply this rule upon to choose. كل الأشياء التي ستقوم بها في حياتك إذا وضعتها تحت هذا المعيار فسوف تفهم دينك بشكل صحيح. I'm gonna give you an example. If you want to do four things, like what? To pray. Okay, Jumu'ah pray. Jumu'ah, I'm gonna say Jumu'ah pray. Okay, to pray, Jumu'ah pray. And you want to play PlayStation. Okay? And you want to study for the test, which is gonna be after 6 months or 6 months later. And also you want to file your taxes, which is gonna be the dead end today. If you are not gonna do it today, you will be in the jail. الأمر الأول أمر الصلاة هام وعاجل صلاة الجمعة هام وعاجل. والأمر الثاني وأمر لعب البلاي ستيشن والجيمز ليس هاما وليس عاجلا. The first thing which is the prayer is important and urgent, but playing games is not important and is not urgent, right? Studying for the test, which is gonna be after 6 months, important but not urgent. هاما وليس عاجلا. مذاكرة الامتحان بعد ستة أشهر. Filing the taxes, which you're gonna have the dead end today. If you are not going today, you know, if you're not gonna file the taxes today, you're gonna be in the jail. You're gonna lose your chance, or you're gonna pay fine or something like that. So what is that? This is ليس هاما لأنك لا تحب أن تفعل ولكنه عاجل. مين فيها بيحب يدفع taxes? Anybody? Nobody. But you have to. You have no choice. So what are you gonna do? You will do it. So anything in this world life gonna be under this one of these four categories. So think about it. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged people or young people to get married, he said that priority for gonna be for whom? فضفر بذاتي الدين. لما شكى الرسول الشباب ان يتزوجوا فضفر بذاتي الدين تربت يدك. هذا ما قاله النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. اظفر بذات الدين. ولما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم للفتاة إذا تقدم إليها أكثر من واحد الأولوية لمن؟ إذا جاءكم من ترضون دينه وخلقه فزوجوه. يبقى الأولوية دائما لصاحب الدين وصاحبة الدين. هذا هو الأهم. تنكح المرأة لأربعة. You know, you would marry any woman for four reasons. For her religion, commitment with Allah, ولمالها for her money, ولحسبها for her ancestors or the family, ولوات لجمالها for her beauty. So the first priority gonna be for what? For her deen, for her religion, for her commitment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can get married of a lady has religion, yes, but if she's beautiful, yeah, no problem, that's good. If she's beautiful and has money, yes, but the first condition, she should have deen first. If she doesn't have deen, but she's beautiful, will you marry her? The answer is, the reality is, yes, everybody's doing that. She's beautiful. This is the most important. She's rich. She's gonna take care of me. Yeah, okay, go ahead. But don't blame anybody but yourself, because you didn't listen to your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So our problem today, that our priorities are messed up. Our priorities are messed up. I'm gonna go back to the categories, but listen to this. We messed up with the priorities. As an example, people, how many people, you know, come to the masjid in Ramadan? A lot. How many people attend the Maghrib and Aisha in masjid every day? Few. Maghrib and Aisha is fard, but praying Taraweeh in Ramadan is sunnah, right? صلاة التراويح سنة وصلاة المغرب والعشاء فريضة، ومع ذلك يقبل الناس على صلاة التراويح أكثر من إقبالهم على صلاة المغرب والعشاء في المسجد. هذه حقيقة. قلت لحضراتكم أولوياتنا لخبطة. We are so confused about our priorities. Our priorities are messed up. So we need to prepare, arrange our life, taking care of ourselves again. This is very important. Wallahi, I'm talking about a very serious matter. Some people think that sleeping is better than going to the masjid to pray Fajr Salah in the masjid. Why? Because I was, subhanAllah, I went to sleep very late yesterday because I was playing games or talking to my friends on the phone or hanging around with somebody or watching something, or I was working so hard till maybe 4 o'clock in the morning. So he thinks sleep right now is better than going to the masjid. What is your evidence? My evidence is Inna Allah Ghafur Rahim. Right? This is the evidence. What about the adhan? When the muazzin says As-salatu khayrun minan naum, what are you gonna say? No. You are wrong. Sleeping is better than the prayer now. So the majority of, not you, all Muslims, the majority of Muslims doing what? They never been in the masjid for Fajr Salah. Because of what? Because he needs to wake up early, maybe 30 minutes later, to go to work. It doesn't matter for him to go to work at 7 o'clock or 7:30 in the morning, because he has to go. He has no choice. But for prayers in the masjid, in the Allah of Allah. You know, some people are working and he cannot stop working under the banner Al-Amal Ibadah. Working is a kind of worship. That's why I'm not gonna stop working for prayers, to do my prayers. This is wrong. Islamically, you need to stop. It doesn't matter what you do, unless your stop gonna affect somebody else. You are a doctor, you are in the middle of surgery or something, okay, you cannot say, I'm gonna stop for 10 minutes to go and pray Dhuhr or Asr or Maghrib. No. You should continue, because now you're stopping and affect somebody else. Fiqh al-awlawiyyat is very important. Understanding our religion is very important. And you will never be able to understand unless you study. Without studying your religion, we're gonna be messed up. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. ثم قلنا أن المسجد لا ينفصل عن الحياة. The masjid will never be separated from the worldly matters. تستطيع أن تمارس حياتك بهذه الطاقة التي اكتسبتها من خطبة الجمعة على سبيل المثال، أو من قيامك خصيصا لصلاة الفجر. لما تأتي لصلاة الفجر وتبدأ يومك مع الله سبحانه وتعالى، ما أجمل هذا اليوم، ما أجمل. عجبت يعني للناس كيف يرزقون، أو كيف يرزق من لا يصلي الفجر. قالوا ذلك، عجبت لمن لا يصلي الفجر كيف يرزق. How Allah is, you know, providing or you know sustaining for the one who doesn't pray Fajr in the masjid. Some scholars said that. عجيب. كيف يرزقه الله. He starts with his day with himself, with anything else, with the worldly issues, because he preferred to sleep or stay in the front of the TV rather than going to the masjid and pray Fajr. I'm talking about something urgent and important. This is urgent and important to come to the masjid. Why? Because this is your duty in Islam. Coming to the masjid, one of your duties. As-salatu khayru minan naum. If you are in the masjid, yes, sadaqa man qala hadha al-kalam. That's true. You're going to say that's true. Prayer is more important than sleeping. But that's not what we are practicing. ليس هذا ما نفعله في هذه الأيام. ما هي الأولويات؟ التي هامت وعاجل. يعني لو قلت لحضراتكم يعني لو ذهبت أنت لتخرج مع أولادك في مكان ما حتى يعني نغير جو، ولكن هذا سيتعارض مع صلاتك المغرب والعشاء، فأي الأولويات تختار؟ أنت قرر. أشياء هامة وعاجلة، وأشياء ليست هامة وليست عاجلة، وأشياء هامة ولكن ليست عاجلة، وأشياء عاجلة ولكن ليست هامة. يعني قرر ماذا ستفعل، لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى لما قال إن عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات، الله سبحانه وتعالى offered the mountain, the heavens, السماوات والأرض والجبال and the earth to take the responsibilities, to take the ability to decide على أن يختاروا التكليفات. فأبينا أن يحملناها وأشفقنا منها وحملها الإنسان. They refused and they felt so bad actually. How come somebody gonna take this trust? وحملها الإنسان. The human being taken. The human being took action. And this is, that's what we are doing right now. You have responsibility. You have a responsibility in the front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about every single action you have to do in this world of life. You should decide everything. So every single decision you're going to make in this holy life, you will be asked upon the Day of Judgments. What is the most important thing and the most urgent thing in this holy life? If you think about it, one thing going to make you so happy in this holy life and going to make you so happy in the Day of Judgments. We said before in khutbah for al-abrar, remember? We were talking about al-abrar. Inna al-abrara lafi na'im. وَإِنَّ الْفُجَّارَ لَفِي جَحِيمٍ يَصْلَوْنَهَا يَوْمًا. So Allah says, the bad people will have a miserable life, okay, in the Day of Judgment. Because bad people, sometimes they're going to have high ranks, high positions in this worldly life. They're going to be so rich, so healthy, so powerful, and they are bad, okay? And you know, and Allah knows they are bad. But Allah says, they're going to be in the hereafter, in the hellfire. But in the abrara, Allah says in abrara, the good people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَفِي نَعِيمٍ. When, where? In this worldly life and in the hereafter. So you have this happiness in this worldly life when you follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, clearly, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. What do you think Allah is calling upon? What? Allah is calling upon who? Us. Not us, actually, Ya ayyuha alladhi, ayyuha means every single one. Ya ayyuha alnamu, udkhulu masakinakum, means all of you, individually and, you know, everybody. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, when you listen to Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, that means Allah is talking to all of us. Yes, all of us in general, but Allah is talking to me. He said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu means me, and you, and him, and him, and me. Allah said that. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ittaqullah. Waltanbur nafsun ma qaddamat lighat. Wattaqullah. Again, inna allaha khabirun bima ta'mal. Allah said, in the end of Surah Al-Hashr, Allah said, O you who believe, O you who claim that they believe, يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنتم قلتم أن لكم أنتم والله الخير. يا أيها الذين آمنوا prove yourself, fear Allah and look what you did for tomorrow. Tomorrow is the Day of Judgment. What did you do for tomorrow? Look at yourself. How did you prepare yourself for tomorrow, for that hereafter? Because tomorrow is coming for sure. No doubt that we're gonna have tomorrow. Allah, what should we do? Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Again, استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. Now we need to stop for a little bit. When Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, oh, you believe, prove yourself, have, respond positively to Allah and His Messenger. استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم. When He calls you to what is better for you, إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ. Respond, how? When you listen that Allah forbid that, Don't do it. Don't do it. When you know this is halal, do it. But if Allah says, don't do that, don't try to find so many excuses for yourself to do it. Just stop. That's it. So easy. But when you, subhanAllah, in this worldly life, sometimes you will face a lot of difficulties. A lot of difficulties. When you try to stop yourself from committing something haram. Allah said, this is forbidden, that's it. What's gonna happen to you? You're gonna die out of hunger? Out of thirst? No. Because Allah is there, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's providing for you. Allah made this is haram as a test for you. Don't do it. What do you think Allah said, you know, told Adam not to eat from this tree for? What do you think? Why Allah told Adam not to eat from this tree? لِمَاذَا نَهَى اللَّهُ آدَمَ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ مِنَ الشَّجَرَةِ كَيْفَ وَلِمَاذَا لِمَاذَا نَهَى اللَّهُ آدَمَ. If you think about it, it was a test. Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam, Adam, don't eat from this tree. You can eat from any other tree in Jannah. How many trees in Jannah? How many? Countless, right? You cannot say 2, 3, 4, 5, countless. If Adam purposely tried to find the tree which Allah prohibited him of eating up, he will never find it. لو بحث آدم عن الشجرة وسط كل هذه الأشجار لما وجدها. لكن لما يأتي الشيطان ويدله هل أدلك؟ أدلك معناها بنفسك ما كنت تستطيع أن تذهب ولا تجدها أبدا لكثرة أشجار الجنة لكثرة الحلال ولكن ضاقت الدنيا ولم يبق إلا هذه الشجرة. نحن أبناء آدم صح؟ هل أدلك على شجرة الخلد وملك لا يبلى؟ Should I guide you to the tree which is gonna make you eternal? Okay, in this world, in this paradise, in this place, should I guide you? It is not the tree of knowledge, okay? Because some understanding or some belief think this is the tree of knowledge. This is wrong. This is the tree of something. He ate from this tree. That's it. Before Adam ate from this tree, Shaitan came again and reminded him. Listen, Allah made this tree prohibited. Allah حرم عليك الأكل من هذه الشجرة. ما نهاكم ربكم عن تلكم الشجرة عن هذه الشجرة إلا أن تكون ملكين أو تكون من الخالقين. Allah didn't say, don't eat, because Allah doesn't want you to be here forever. Because if once you're gonna eat, you will be here forever. You will be turned in this life. Or maybe you're gonna be an angel. So what do you think Adam did? Adam ate from the tree. What is this tree? And why Allah prohibited him from eating from this tree? Very obvious. It was a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لأنه لا بركة في شخص لا يفعل المنكرات. غريبة. نعم. لا بركة في شخص لا يفعل المنكرات لأنه غير قادم عليها. اكتملت الصورة. Somebody doesn't drink wine. Why? Because there is no wine in this city. This is the reason. Okay? Somebody doesn't commit adultery. Why? Because all people are good in this place. You cannot find anybody. That doesn't make you good. That doesn't make you good. If you didn't find a way to disobey Allah, but الشخص الذي يحبه رب العالمين هو الشخص الذي يوجد في وسط هذه المعاصي والموبقات ولكنه يبقى سليما. Everyone drinking wine, but I'm not gonna do it. Everybody committing adultery, but I'm not gonna do it. For the sake of Allah, Allah is watching me. لن أقوم بهذا العمل لأن الله يراني. هذا هو استجيبوا لله وللرسول. النهي عن أكل الشجرة رغم كثرة الحلال إلا أنه ما رأى إلا هذه الشجرة. We have so many halal things. How many drink in this world of life is halal? Lemon juice, orange juice, water, everything. How many drink is haram or forbidden? Wine. That's it. Don't drink wine. No, people actually have to drink wine. Why? Because this is the only thing. And this is the human being nature actually. هذه طبيعة الناس. لو قيل لرجل أهل العراق عالم عراقي والذي قال نساء العراق كلهن ملك يمينك إلا هذه المرأة. كل نساء العراق millions of ladies are yours whatever do whatever you want except this lady. He will forget about all ladies and start to think about this lady. Why not this one? Why not? تصد الأميرة اللي حرم عليها سبع غرف حرم عليها غرفة واحدة في القصر لا تدخلي هذه الغرفة إياك بس عندك ما شاء الله في القصر سبع غرف ألعاب وجيمز وأشياء كثيرة جدا نسيت إيه سبع غرف وظلت تفكر في الغرفة فالله سبحانه وتعالى جعل أشياء كثيرة حلال وحرم القليل ولما حرم رب العالمين سبحانه وتعالى القليل حرمه لمصلحة لك أنت حرمه لمصلحة لك أنت حتى لا أطيل عليك إن شاء الله اسمع إلى ما هو بعدي دائما وأبدا تبدأ بنفسك أخي في الله لا تفكر في إصلاح الآخرين طالما أنك لا تستطيع أن تصلح نفسك قلت لحضراتكم مرارا وتكرارا ستعلم كم هو صعب التغيير لما تبدأ بتغيير نفسك طالما أنك تفكر في تغيير الآخرين تظن أن الأمر في منتهى السهولة يا أخي ده ما بيعرفش يصلي يا أخي ده بيقول كذا ده بيتصرف بالطريقة الفلانية وأنا قلت له ولن يستجب أنت معتقد الموضوع سهل التغيير سهل لكن لو في شخص قال لك أنت مخطئ في شيء ما ويجب أن تغير ستعلم مدى صعوبة التغيير وطالما أنك غير قادر على أن تغير من نفسك لن تستطيع أن تغير العالم من حولك المسلمون لن يغيروا العالم طالما هم بهذه الصورة Muslims will never be able to change the world unless they change themselves so we should start from ourselves that's what exactly Allah says in the Quran and quickly if you are in the airplane going back home traveling from place to place what is the first thing in this trip gonna happen What is the first thing gonna happen? The captain or the anybody gonna hold the microphone and start to talk to people, right? Unlikely accident happens sometimes. So if something happens, you're gonna find that oxygen mask falling down from above. Help yourself before you help other people, right? That's what they're doing. When I was first time on the airplane, I was listening. Help yourself before you help other people. I was thinking, if I have a 4-year-old kid beside me, it is a kind, sounds like selfish, right? If I'm gonna help myself and don't help him, he said, no, help yourself first, right? If I should start with the kid, but if I lost breath, okay, and I help the kid, I'm not gonna be able to help anybody else, right? So when I help myself first, I will be able to save the kid, save everybody else. If you have a piece of food and you are drowning, and you have a kid drowning too, what gonna happen? You should go and save him first, or try to get this piece of wood first. Piece of wood first, because you can save him with this. But without this, you're gonna go down on him too. هذا فقه الأولويات. المقدمات في الإسلام هذا في غاية الأهمية قالها الله سبحانه وتعالى صريحة يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا مين أنفسكم or you believe protect first yourself أنفسكم everybody is talking you know Allah is talking to everybody or you believe قوا أنفسكم first fix yourself correct your actions do good things and then you will be able to save other people your family First, family first, second, after yourself. قوا أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا وقودها الناس والحجارة. And this ayah actually, one of the most merciful ayahs in the Quran. The Quran is very merciful, right? Have a lot of mercy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have a merciful Quran. لكن من أكثر الآيات رحمة في هذا القرآن هذه الآية. تدري لماذا؟ لما جلس بعض الصالحين في المسجد يتدارسون القرآن فقال أحدهم ما أرحم آية في كتاب الله What do you think? ما هي أرجى آية? What is the most merciful آية in the book of Allah? One of them says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَى أَنفُسِهِمْ. Oh my servants, don't be despaired of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't matter how much sins you made, just come back to Allah. Says, you're right. And the other one says what? وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ سُوءًا أَوْ يَظْلِمْ نَفْسَهُ ثُمَّ يَسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهَ يَجْدِ اللَّهَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Whoever gonna commit a sin or oppress himself or wrongdoer himself, you know, and come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is waiting for him. يَجْدِ اللَّهَ, Allah is waiting for him, and he's the most merciful, most forgiving. He says, but I think something else. I think one of the most important and the most merciful ayat in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. Oh, you believe, protect yourself or prevent yourself and your family of the hellfire. Of the hellfire. من الأولويات وفقه الأولويات درء المفسدة مقدم على جلب المصلحة. To protect yourself is more important than gaining something good. And Sheikh Sha'rawi rahmatullah alayhi gave a beautiful example. If somebody has an apple and he said, oh, Muhammad, take this. Wow, this is a gift. And actually he do it nicely when he's brought a gift, something like that. Oh, you're waiting for the apple, right? And somebody else at the same time is throwing you with a rock towards you. So you have the apple that's coming and the rock is coming. Which is more important? To avoid this rock or to grab the apple? To grab the apple? So many people were doing that, actually. They like apples and they don't care about what's gonna happen. But actually, it is very, very important to avoid the rock. I'm not gonna say your judgment. If your mom's there and watching, she's gonna say, grab the apple. We're gonna say, watch out. What are you gonna say? Watch out, be careful. That's what we need to do with ourselves and our families. قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هَاتُوا أُولَادَكُمْ شَجَّعُهُمْ وَتَعَالُوا ادْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ مَعَ بَعْضِهِمْ. Yeah, that's for the Quran has a lot of ayat like that. But this is the most important one. To avoid what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid upon you. اتَّقِ الْمَحَارِمَ تَكُنْ أَعْبَدَنَّاسْ. You will be the best worshiper of Allah if you're going to avoid what Allah prohibited upon you. لو اتقيت ما حرم الله عليك تكون أفضل العباد أقرب الناس إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى. Okay? So we have the Super Bowl. When? Of course, someday. You're going to act like you don't know. What is the meaning of Super Bowl? Okay. Everybody wants to watch the Super Bowl. Okay? But if that gonna contradict with the Maghrib Salah, what are you gonna do? Priorities. Priorities. You are not going to die. You are not going to go to the hellfire if you didn't watch the Super Bowl. Nobody gonna go to the hellfire. Okay? But you're gonna go to the hellfire if you're not gonna pray. Right? I'm gonna pray later. What's wrong with that? If you can do that with no excuse, Allah will never mention the Quran. Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. You should pray on the time, unless you have an excuse. And you will be judged. What is your excuse? Why did you delay this prayer? Get ready, because you will answer. You will answer. Okay, why did they make Hajj till now? Why? Hajj is obligation, once in the lifetime. Why did they make Hajj? The priorities. Somebody gonna say, oh Allah, because last year I took my family for vacation and went to Hawaii. We enjoyed that. So I spent the whole money for the vacation. What about Hajj? What about Hajj? Another person came, said, oh Allah, you know that. I had a son. And this son in very dangerous situation. He was in America. A lot of fitan, a lot of seductions in America. So I spend this money to get him married. Is that acceptable? Yes! Which one is more important? You to get married, or your son to get married, or Hajj? No, to get married is more important than Hajj. الأولويات. هذا فقه. أقول لحضراتكم الأولويات. Again, لو أمك بتناديك يا فلان وهو وانت تصلي، لان هذا حدث مع برصيص العابد، كان يصلي وامه تناديه فلم يجب امه فدعت عليه واستجاب الله دعاءها. نص الحديث، روح كده دور على برصيص العابد وان داي ان شاء الله بيجينا منشن بيستوري. He was a good worshiper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he didn't have this understanding. So what happened? His mom called him. And what happened? He didn't respond. Because I'm Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah. Oh, Barsisa, wait, I'm praying. No, if this is a voluntary prayer, sunnah, tatawwu', idhhab wa istajib li min li ummika awwala. Birru al-walidayn muqaddamun 'ala birri al-abna'. أتعلم ذلك؟ بر الأبناء أن تتقي الله فيهم، تطول معنا أن تتقي الله في أبنائك، ولكن إذا خيرت بين بر الآباء وبر الأبناء، إذا كان يتعارض الأمر أيهما تقدم؟ بر الآباء، رغم أنهما كبيران في السن والخرف قد أصاب منهم ما أصاب، ينسيان والزهايمر الحصر والشركة، بر الآباء مقدم على بر الأبناء. ما الدليل على ذلك؟ فكان الثلاثة اللي أغلق عليهم الغار، واحد منهم جاب الحليب، الرأي الإخوة الفلسطينيين، اللبن عندنا في مصر، جاب اللبن وجاء ليسقي أباه وأمه، فوجد أبناءه يضوعون جوعا وأباه وأمه نائمة، فانتظر حتى استيقظ ولم يسقي. جزاكم الله خيرا. يعني we have a lot of details, a lot of stories, a lot of you know things to mention about فقه الأولويات, understanding your religion. Your goal, which you're going to be defined, should be identified right now to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And now, from now, you should start to give a commitment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, now on, till I die, my intention not to disobey you, to do whatever going to please you. It doesn't matter how much people are going to be angry or upset with me. I don't care about people. I care about your acceptance. الذي يهمني هو رضاك، هو رضاك. ونسأل الله أن يرضى عنا أجمعين. اللهم ارضى عنا يا رب العالمين، اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم مرضانا، واختم بالباقيات الصالحات أعمالنا، أكرمنا ولا تهنا، وزدنا ولا تنقصنا، وأعطنا ولا تحرمنا، وكن لنا ولا تكن علينا. اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم مرضانا، واختم بالباقيات الصالحات أعمالنا يا كريم. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.